Tell me about your relationship with the manager.
I think we had a good relationship. I mean, obviously, I think the art what Kenny had, that he could be one of the boys. I mean, we all ate on the same table. I mean, throughout my career, it's very, very unusual. You know, it's usually when you go into hotels now, they've already got staff written on tables and players on another one. So it was them and us. It's something what I've learned in management. I get rid of them signs now and I try and sit with the boys. And when I sit next to them, they go...
Have to be on best behaviour.
Yeah. Well, no, but they realise that I'm treating them as a man. I'm just one of them, you know. But I think your dad was like that. But you knew, as my players do now, know when it's game time and know when you have to laugh and a joke and have to stop and who the boss is.
I wonder if that came from the fact that you'd been a player and a player manager before you became sort of manager on its own. That sort of wanting to be. Everyone to be part of the same team?
Well, we're all part of the same team. Everybody's looking to the same end, aren't they? For me, I don't think you get respect by being aloof. I think you get respect for being yourself. And if they don't like you, they don't like you. They've got to respect the position and they've got to respect the fact that as a manager, you're going to make decisions. Sometimes it might not be good for them, but you're not doing it because anything other than you want the team to win. And that's what everybody wants to do at the end of the day. Me sitting at a separate table, that doesn't make any difference to me. I don't want to be above the players. I'll treat them with respect if they're treating me with respect. And you've got to earn the respect that you get. And by sitting at another table, I don't think you earn respect.
Yeah, but I wonder if it's then a little bit, you know, at times when you need to keep a distance, does it make it a bit harder?
No, it makes it hard. But then it's the decision that you're making on behalf of everybody. And for me, I always wanted to be a player anyway. I enjoyed that better than being manager. And maybe it was me, it was frustrated. Maybe that's why I sat with him. Yeah. And I can imagine their faces if I sat beside them going, oh, no, no, this.
Yeah, you got to sit and listen to it.
I love the banter, I love the cry, I love getting in amongst the boys. And I knew that there was a time for me to stay out the road because they had their own discussions to be had.
Mm. Tim, would you accept that we weren't the best probably football team in the world, but we had an unbelievable team spirit. I mean, we were just saying beforehand that we were probably won the league a year before, but if it wasn't for the midfielders not chipping in enough goals. So, would you accept that the team spirit that we had at Blackburn got us over the line?
Oh, well, without a doubt. I think that the team spirit, what we had there was ridiculous. I mean, but on some of the things we used to get up to, I'm not sure if we could say.
Yeah, no, do. Go on.
I couldn't, but it was not right, is it? I mean, now you just wouldn't believe it. I mean, nothing untoward, but just banter, and we called it banter. I'm sure what people call it now. But it was just a fantastic spirit and togetherness, you know, of everyone involved. There was no hierarchy in the dressing room, you know, everyone was on a level playing field, and I think that we all wanted the same thing, and we all treated each other with that utmost respect. I mean, going back to the table thing, we used to have Stoney, the coach driver, sitting on the table. I mean, I tell you now, that is unheard of. The coach driver even to be in the same room as the players. This doesn't even happen, but we used him as the fun piece, weren't we, at some nights, you know. He was a great lad, and he was a fantastic character. We had Colin, the ex-boxer who was there as a masseur. He's never recognised anyone in his life. And we made sure that we got him on the bonuses. You know, so these guys, what they were earning with the bonus, I'm not sure. I think we was on a grand a point or something like that. We did accumulate quite a few points over them years. he can't believe his luck. This fella comes from Blackpool. You know, we put him on a percentage of the bonuses because we believe that everyone travelling with the squad should be part of it, and it weren't only about money, because that guy, even if you give him nothing, he would have treated us the same way. He felt that he owed us something, and we never treated him any differently than we would to our big money signing.
I wonder if some of that sort of atmosphere around the club and that sense of everybody being together comes from the fact that the man who owns the club was a Blackburn Rovers fan, did stand on the terraces, did have that connection at every level.
I can just imagine Tim reacting to some of his players now, some of the antics that we got up to, whether we'd accept the same from his players.
Now is that, listen, you ain't done nothing what I haven't done.
Very true.
They might score a goal.